Congratulations, fifth grade class of 2020. Here you are. You made it. You're at the finish line of your ASL journey. And I hope that you're feeling as proud of yourself as I am for you. For many of you, this could mean wrapping up the last 6 years of your life, walking the halls of our colorful campus. And for some of you, this journey started recently. But for all of you, Aveson has been your home. It's where you've learned to be yourself, love yourself, appreciate others, and grow into the compassionate and bold, authentic person you are right in this moment. What a gift to celebrate. A place like Aveson, we all get to share together. And I'm pretty sure many of you were not expecting to celebrate it in the way we are in these times. What I can assume is that you were looking forward to traditions of being in the auditorium and on stage dressed in your best with your hair did and seeing your family cheering you on in the audience. Perhaps you were excited to shake the hands of your advisors as you walked off stage, beaming in pride that you are holding that certificate tight in your excited hands, knowing that you finally did it. You're done. Truthfully, you deserve to have a memory that everyone that has sat in your place years before had. And I'm sorry that it isn't the vision you had for yourself for all of these years. But that word, vision, it reminds me of my favorite guiding principle. Vision means seeing what could be and what will be and living the difference. And as you get older, you will learn that we didn't expect certain things. And those things that we didn't expect tend to teach us the most about who we are and what the world needs from us. So many of you have already shown such resilience through these times, and all of you, through your Aveson ways of learning and loving, have the capacity to see a bright future after all of this strangeness is done. You are all creative, empathetic, and curious, and I can't wait to see what we all learn from these times and what your future brings. What I want us to think about now, though, is what we can create. Even in this different celebration, what feeling can we honor? I say gratitude. The gratitude that we had the chance to spend these times together, learning, laughing, growing. Out of all the schools in the world, we all ended up here together. I want to celebrate gratitude that our community celebrates diversity, our identities, and asks to hear our voices. And I want to celebrate that gratitude that traditions like how we're celebrating Culmination right now can change, but the feeling of accomplishment with the memories you've got here can never be taken from you. You are all in a moment of your lives where even more change is on the horizon, not just due to this strange quarantine times, but also because of all the new that is ahead of you. New friends, schools, teachers, assignments, routines, cultures, ideas. And you're ready for it all because you have the Aveson heart, the Aveson courage, and the Aveson brain. And don't worry if you need a reminder of or a motivating high five, or just need a little peek and see too because you missed the room. You can always just click your heels and come back to your home, Aveson. You will be missed, but you are so ready for this next step. Now go out there and live your best life.
Life is like riding a bicycle. To keep your balance, you must keep riding. Albert Einstein. Hi, I am Camila Siri Andresen Cesar. I have attended Aveson School of Leaders for 7 years, and this year definitely seems to be the most interesting of all. I will forever be grateful for all of my teachers and peers who have helped me grow by teaching me how to look on the bright side of life. Right now, life seems like a game with a lot of rules and boundaries because of the pandemic. I'm still trying to figure out if I'm in a wild dream of some sort, waiting to wake up in a daze. No one expected us to have more than 2 weeks of distance learning, and let's be honest, life seems much more difficult than how it used to be. But if we look on the bright side, we've had much more time to spend with our pets and family, even if it's over Zoom, FaceTime, house party, or any other connecting sites. Not to mention, we actually have time to practice activities we didn't have time to before the pandemic. For instance, I've been practicing my guitar skills. Aveson has given me a chance not only to be positive, but also a leader. One example of me being a leader is when last month I reached out to my friends and asked them to write about how they feel about quarantine, missing the traditional culmination ceremony, and not going to Catalina Island. Then I sent an email with our thoughts to my teachers, school director, and school administrator. I hope other actions like this will catch on more as I grow, because a few years ago, I would have never seen myself talking to my friends for school purposes or taking on leadership without being asked. I hope everyone in the audience will have a chance to make a difference like mine. Maybe you will make a smaller impact or maybe bigger, but if we are all driven by passion and an interest to making a positive change for animals, family, your school, your city, and maybe even the world, we can make a difference. Moving on will be pretty hard as I know, but I'm looking forward to doing harder things and going with the flow. Finally, I would like to thank my mom, / my personal speech evaluator for helping me with this speech. May we all be safe, happy, and have a mindset to keep moving forward. Thank you.
Hello, 2020 fifth grade culminating class. I am extremely, extremely proud of you all and so excited for the adventures you're going to have in middle school. I would like to leave you with some words. These come from the poster we had in that safe place area in our classroom. And the title of the poster was "What I Want Every Student of Mine to Know." There are six. I would like to leave you with these words. Number one, you can do anything you want in life with hard work, grit, and determination. Two, sometimes things will be difficult, but you can get through them. Three, I will believe in you, even if you struggle with believing in yourself. Four, you are unique, and that makes you who you are as a person. Five, you're going to make mistakes, and that's okay. Learn from them. And six, you matter, you've got this, you are loved, and you truly are loved. From the moment you guys stepped into my classroom, every ounce of my being has loved you, has valued you, has cherished you, and I'm just extremely overwhelmed with the thought that I got to experience your fifth grade year with you. I'm very thankful for that, and I just want to wish you all the very best in middle school. I would love to give you all a hug right now. Unfortunately, they're air hugs, so imagine yourself hugged. And since this era of your life, many of you are into TikToks, I thought I'd leave you with the gift of a TikTok. So be prepared. I hope you enjoyed that TikTok. That was lots of fun making. Thank goodness I had my daughter to help me. All right, friends, I am going to end my video with you. I'm going to end it with one of my favorite people of all times, and that is Mr. Rogers. He gave a commencement speech years ago, and his final words I thought would be perfect to end this with. So I love you. Congratulations.
So in all that you do, in all of your life. I wish you the strength and the grace to make those choices which will allow you and your neighbor to become the best of whoever you are. Congratulations to you all.
Congratulations, ASL Class of 2020! I'm so proud of each and every one of you. I have loved laughing with you and learning with you. You're all so amazing in your own unique and beautiful way. Being part of your life's journey has been my honor, truly. I love you all so much. Continue the journey. Be you. Be true. Find your voice. Speak yourself. You can change the world, and I know you will.
No matter who you are, where you're from, your skin color, your gender identity, just speak yourself. Find your name and find your voice by speaking yourself.
You've got a friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. Got a friend in me.
Hello, friends, family, teachers, and staff. Look at us. We did it. We're all fifth graders. Wow, it's been a long journey through the years. From our informative SLCs, dazzling spotlight performances, exhilarating jogathons, impressive COOs, and ending off the year with a bang at the June Jubilee. We've gained lots of friends throughout those years, and I've made many amazing memories with them. And I think it is especially important that I thank every teacher, IA, staff member, and parent volunteer who's been there for me when I needed help or just a moment to share some exciting news. What's the next step? Middle school, a time where we're all becoming responsible young adults. A time where we all start a new journey, a journey with twists and turns, but all of us would thrive in middle school because of Aveson's golden rules. We've learned to use them early on, both in school and out. And Aveson has taught me something that I will never forget. And that's you have to take risks, because the risks that we take and the choices we make make us who we are. And finally, to quote the great Michelle Obama, don't be afraid. Be focused, be determined, be hopeful, be empowered. Thank you, class of 2020.
Dear fifth graders, I am so incredibly happy for you. I am proud of you. And I cannot wait for you to embark on this journey and come back and tell us all the amazing things that I'm sure you are all off to doing in middle school, in high school, and beyond. We've talked a lot about leadership this year. What makes a good leader? What is a leader? How to lead? And now more than ever, we need leaders. We need you. And one thing we hadn't really had a chance to talk about is leaders
who are amazing really know who they are deep down inside. You can always turn to yourself, to trust yourself to know how to lead. I'm going to borrow some words from an author by the name of Amy Krauss Rosenthal. And these words are to inspire you to know about yourself, to keep digging deeper, to learn, and to grow. Arm raise. You have smart things to say. Sometimes you may feel like being pink and sparkly. Sometimes you may feel pretty much the opposite. Look at yourself in the mirror. Say thank you to something that makes you you. Thank you, freckles. Thank you, glasses. Thank you, birthmark. Thank you, red hair. Sometimes you just need a good cry. Sometimes you'll need a friend. Sometimes you'll need to be alone. Sometimes you'll need a tissue, and sometimes you'll need a whole bucket. Do you know that there is no such thing as asking too many questions? Who, what, when, where, why, how? Never be afraid to be curious. Write down your thoughts once in a while, even if it's just to enjoy the way your pen feels against the paper. Make your room your space. Awesome. Make your space you. And while you're at it, make your bed. Don't ever lose your sense of wonder. Just gotta stop and dance. Find people like you and find people unlike you. Create traditions. Create fun, crazy handshakes. Create silly inside jokes. If your instinct is telling you to say no, say no, you know? Coloring outside the lines is cool too. There are no rules about what to wear or how to cut your hair. You know what's really boring? When people say how bored they are. Listen to your brave side. Be daring. Be bold. You won't be invited to every single party on the planet, which is really okay, because can you imagine how exhausting that would be? A tree trunk is the perfect place for quiet thoughts to be thunk. Whenever you need an encouraging boost, remember, you can always turn to you. Trust yourself. Have the confidence to know you've got this. You have always been a leader. You always will be. I wish you well and congratulations.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
I came to Aveson when I was 7.5 years old, just after first grade. The reason we switched was my brother Dante. He was too smart for his old public school, so he was misbehaving due to boredom. I, on the other hand, was the exemplary, perfect child who always behaved perfectly and needed no intervention. At least, that was what we thought. In 2016, I went from the Montebello School District to Aveson, Altadena. Our move was so far, our commute time jumped from a mere 6 minutes to 80 minutes, but it's all been worth it because of what I've learned from Aveson. Although I appeared to be the perfect student, I was not without problems. The first of which was that I was perfectionistic and rigid. As a result of that, for the first 2 years, I didn't have a lot of friends, and perhaps the worst part was that I didn't see it as a problem. I am very appreciative to my advisor of 4 years. She has always been sensitive enough to spot my issues, but at the same time, she was patient enough to let me realize them myself. For example, she would always create opportunities for me to work with, play with, and eat with different students. She would also privately discuss and advise me about my experiences with different kids. It was as though she was inviting me to see all the possibilities of friendships, but at the same time, she honored my personality by allowing me to have as many or as few friends as I'd like, and in my own timing. Thanks to the flexibility that Aveson has afforded me, I was able to join the upper elementary class even though I was just a second grader. While I was fairly independent as a young student in class, I didn't have much of a plan for success. I guess for the first 2 years, my plan was to just get by, using my more outgoing brother as a social crutch. It was Aveson's school of leaders, right? I could let the other kids be the leaders, and I could be the happy follower that every leader needs. Wrong, because my teacher did not allow that option. Miss Laura often took the time to ask me for ideas to lead the class. It's almost like she invited me to co-facilitate the class with her. Last year, Miss Laura invited me to suggest ideas for class activities. I had a knack in biology and was taking a high school biology class, so I recommended dissection. To my absolute surprise, she went out to order dissection kits and microscopes for the whole class, and we did a whole unit on biology and the class dissected orthopods. I am not even sure how to tell you about my development during my time here at Aveson. I guess you could compare it to the Cambrian explosion. The same advisor I had for all 4 years has ever so persistently championed me. Because of that, I feel like I was given permission to speak up for myself. Because she is so respectful to my sensitivities, I learned to own up to them myself. Because of the constant exposure to leadership ideas in the past 4 years, it has loosened me up. I don't have to pretend I blend in because my voice matters. Sharing my ideas,
and positively impact my classroom and my community. Here, positive contribution is valued, and my respectful dissent is welcomed. I can be lighthearted, flexible, and I can show my sense of humor. I can build deeper and stronger relationships with my peers, and not just the ones who are my close friends. I can tolerate differences and even embrace them and be kind to those who believe differently. I can be more curious and less judgmental. So, although I wasn't the kid who had more overt issues, my weaknesses didn't go unnoticed by my teacher. She helped me become more aware of them and constantly challenged me to address them. This is what I think I can only get from Aveson.
Congratulations, fifth graders. Virtual hug. Middle school is next. You're moving on from Aveson School of Leaders. You have built such a foundation here. Know that even when the foundation feels a little bit shaky, the ground feels a little bit shaky, that you can remember all the tools and things that you learned here to get grounded. All about everything you learned about community, about collaboration, about passion, about mindfulness and peace. All of those things, all of those are far more contagious than COVID-19. So take everything in your heart, and so excited for what is next for you. If you only remember two things, I want you to remember to always speak and listen, or to remind yourself when possible to speak and listen from your heart. Not how people are saying something, but what they're saying from their heart. And always remind you to come back to speaking from your heart. And the other thing is, don't just be you. Okay? Be community and be a leader, because you already are. Virtual hug. Congratulations. We're family. Visit us.
Morning, afternoon, and evening. Wow, I've been going to Aveson for so long, it's really difficult to imagine not going there. I'm gonna miss so much about it. Talking with my friends on the blacktop, joking with my advisors, art with Miss Heather, culinary art with Miss Arlen, being stuck on the last problem of a worksheet while everyone else moves on to free time. Okay, maybe not the last one. Everything else about Aveson is amazing, and I'm really, really sad to leave it behind. Let me tell you a story. It was the first day of first grade, and I was so, so nervous. I didn't know any of these kids. I was glad to have my sister in the same class, but I was still just so scared that I wasn't gonna make any friends at all. Then a girl walked up to me, and I asked her if she wanted to be friends. She said yes, and we are still friends, even now. She has taught me so much, and thanks to her, I have other friends too. As I said, I'm really sad to leave Aveson behind, but I'm very grateful for this chance to go on and keep learning. Everyone here has taught me so much, from addition and subtraction to how to braid my hair. I will remember everything you have taught me and will use it every day. I'm sure that all of you, staff included, will do great things. Remember, keep moving forward, making new friends, and learning new things. Goodbye, I miss you already.
Dear Aveson fifth grade students and families, I've never ever given a fifth grade culmination speech like this before, remotely, on video. You know what that means? It's the most memorable school year ending ever. Right now, I wish I could magically transport us all to the stage in the auditorium at ASL. That's why I'm wearing my graduation robe. It always feels magical to put this on. If we were together at school for this special event, I would get to see and hear your advisors talking to your family members about how much you've grown and learned over the course of your elementary years. Even though I don't get to see that, we all know it is true. You did it. You finished fifth grade. Your families are so proud of you. Your advisors are smiling ear to ear. And me, I don't really need magic. The magic is in all of you as you go on to sixth grade. The magic of using your voice, your mind, your heart for learning and for your community. Today, we honor you for the culmination of your learning at Aveson School of Leaders. Congratulations, fifth grade class of 2020.
Antonio Silva. On the behalf of all my fellow fifth graders, I would like to thank the teachers, parents, family, and friends for attending our fifth grade culmination. This is the school I will remember all my life. I have had a great time at Aveson, and I am very sad to leave. So many memories are rushing through my brain. The talent show, the campouts, COL, I will miss everything, and I hope to see many of your faces again. Aveson is a unique and safe place. It's like a second home to me. No homework was a blast, and we are put at our own pace for the best guaranteed education. Aveson teaches you to follow your dreams and never let anyone put you down. At Aveson, you are allowed to be yourself. Everyone is accepted, and you can explore your interests and passions. These are the greatest parts I have experienced at Aveson. It was nice to see the progression of the passion projects. I enjoyed the process of this work, and they always turned out pretty well for mine and others. Aveson is not a school where you work apart, you work together. I love Aveson because I have come a long way on my own path, and on that path, Aveson was able to make sure that I went the right way. I am prepared for middle school, and Aveson made that happen. Finally, fellow fifth graders, as we look forward to our next stage in life, middle school, let us commit to use all the knowledge and skills we have learned so far. By doing so, we will be successful in all that is set before us. Let us be committed to be the best that we can and make our teachers, parents, families, and friends proud of us. The future is yours. Go for the win and make your mark. Thank you.
Hello, Aveson graduates, families, and staff. As the founder of Aveson Charter Schools 13 years ago, I would never have imagined I'd be recording my talk for the fifth grade 2020 graduation. Graduates, let me begin by saying I am so sorry you don't have the opportunity to have the live ceremony you deserve. I can imagine it doesn't feel good to work so hard for so many years and now not be able to celebrate with friends, family, and advisors. I am grateful to the Aveson staff who were determined to celebrate you the best way we can during this time. I'm sure people have told you there are many lessons to be learned during challenging times. This is true, and you know as Aveson students that you have the resilience and the creativity to make the best of a tough situation. Through your years of take action and passion projects, you've learned to look beyond yourself and make a difference in the world. I know you will do the same now. I think you already knew how much the staff at Aveson cared about you and your learning when you were at school. I hope now you realize how much we care about you and your learning when you could not be at school. Please remember this as you leave ASL and continue your journey to middle school. The love and pride we have for you will always be there, even if you don't see us every day. Families, thank you for putting your trust in Aveson. We are grateful for your support, and we commend you on the extraordinary job that you have done over the past few weeks balancing distance learning, your work, and family responsibilities. I hope you take the time to honor what you have done. So, graduates, I'll finish with a little secret. People always ask me, which of the guiding principles is my favorite? I respond with, they're like my children. I don't really have a favorite. The truth is, I actually do have a favorite. My favorite guiding principle is vision means seeing what could be and what will be and living the difference. You all are living the difference right now, and I know the vision of our world will be clearer with you as leaders. Thanks for listening, and congratulations.
Best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest.
You could beat the world, you could beat the war. You could talk the guy, go banging on his door.
You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock,
yeah.
You can move a mountain, you can break rocks.
You could be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself.
Standing in the Hall of Fame,
yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name. You can run the mile. You can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're